It has been about 5.5 weeks since I had my reconstructive knee surgery. I'll link above the video that I posted about the knee surgery, the video that I had made from the day of the surgery, and then it was a 2-week update and I explained everything that I had done to my knee. And I just wanted to share all of the products and items that I've been using since the surgery during my recovery. It has been a long 5.5 weeks, but these things have made it a little bit easier, so I wanted to share them just in case you are gonna have to go through a knee surgery, or maybe just any type of surgery, and I'm gonna have to have that same surgery done to my other knee. Probably gonna wait a year until I get it done, but this way I don't forget all of the things that I have found very helpful during my recovery. This first thing I actually received as a gift. My grandmom got me this. This is like a nightgown sort of thing, like a lounge dress. It's so soft. It has a hood and it's long sleeves. It's from the brand Simply Vera. That's the Vera Wang brand, I think, at Kohl's. It's just a super soft nightgown. I'm not really a nightgown person, so I didn't own anything like this, so I'm glad that I received this before my surgery, because the hospital had given me a list of things that I might want to bring to have for right after the surgery, and they had on there like a robe. I didn't end up bringing a robe, but I brought this, and I don't know what I would have done without it, because at that point in my surgery, my leg was completely numb. I was not moving. I was not agile enough to get pants on. This I could just like slip over my body, and since it was New Year's Eve when I had my surgery, and it was like raining and kind of snowing, it was very cold. This was nice for the ride home. I was actually wearing this for a while just because I couldn't move to put on any pants, and eventually at home I switched into this gigantic t-shirt. It's like a 4XL men's t-shirt that I had gotten on sale from the Disney store. There was no way that I was going to be getting pants on. I had to live in my knee brace for the first week, and I thought that I would be able to put pants on. I had purchased really huge pajama pants before the surgery because I figured, oh, that'll be great. It'll go right over the brace and I'll be fine, but I couldn't even like think about putting pants on at that point. So having like a big shirt, a nightgown, or something like this to put on, especially in the hospital, was super helpful. Eventually, once I was able to move around a little bit more, I decided that I was going to be more comfortable wearing shorts. So I ended up getting these shorts from Amazon. They're just super soft pajama shorts, and I bought two different sizes, like the biggest sizes that they had, because I wanted to make sure that they like would fit over top of the knee brace. And these have been the best thing. So I'm actually going to link these. They're like no brand that I've ever heard of, but I'll link the Amazon link in the description below. So if you're in the market for like really soft pajama shorts, they're so stretchy, they're so soft, they're not like constricting at all. Well, that's because I bought like the biggest sizes, but I really like them. I actually really enjoyed having huge sizes, because when I am wearing my brace, it really scratches up the inside of my other leg that the brace isn't on. It's nice that the shorts are a little bit longer to like cover the brace to protect my legs. I am not wearing pants when I'm wearing the brace. I can't really wear any clothing underneath the brace. It just falls if I wear anything under there. So I'm wearing shorts every time that I leave the house. When I go to physical therapy, I'm in shorts. So I've really been enjoying these, and they turned out to be so much better than I expected since they were just from Amazon. After that first week, once I started physical therapy, I felt more comfortable not wearing the brace when I was just in bed. And since there was constantly ice on my leg, I was freezing cold all the time. So I did want to wear pants. So I have these pants. These are actually just from Target. I don't know if they still have these, but they're just like a comfortable soft pajama pant, but they like come together at the bottom. It's like a jogger style or like sweatpants style pant. They stay like on my ankle rather than like flaring out. And I have tried regular pajama pants, and I prefer these just because the regular pajama pants get stuck on things and they're always too long because I'm kind of short. So these have just been a little bit more safe. So I do recommend, if you're going to wear pants after a knee surgery, if you're like on crutches, definitely wear something that is gonna be safe, isn't going to like get caught on your crutches or on anything really. I prefer a pair of pants with this sort of thing at the bottom. And my last like clothing type of item is socks with the plastic grip things on them. These were the ones that they actually gave me at the hospital. If you are planning on wearing socks and using crutches, I don't recommend anything else other than something with plastic on the bottom. I haven't really worn socks much at home because I couldn't really put socks on or take them off easily, so I didn't really want to wear them. And the first like week and a half, 2 weeks of my recovery, my right foot was completely swollen. Like, socks would hardly even fit on that foot, so I wasn't really wearing socks. But if you're going to wear socks and walk around your house, like, we have hardwood floors in my house, you're gonna want to wear something with a grip on the bottom because that's super dangerous. And the ones from the hospital are fine. My next tip is to have ice packs of varying sizes. At the hospital, they gave me this big, I don't even know where it is because I've never used it. It's like this big foam thing that fits four of this type of ice pack in them, and you're supposed to be able to like wrap it around your leg, but the foam on it's way too thick and you don't actually feel any of the coolness from it, and the ice packs fall out too quick. So I never used that. I just took the ice packs out and I've been using these. So I have four of these. Since they do thaw out so quickly, it is good to have many of them so you can have extra frozen ones in the freezer. But these are good because they're super lightweight, and there are times where my knee hurts too much to like put ice packs on there because of the pressure of the ice pack. So these are good for that just because they're super light. But my favorite type of ice pack that I have been using during my recovery is a gigantic bag of peas. My parents filled up long bags, like the plastic bags that a newspaper comes in. They filled those up with frozen peas, and they're the best ice packs. They last forever. It takes so long for them to thaw out. So I really like those because I'm not having to switch out the ice packs a lot. I mentioned that in that last video that I made about my knee. Moving around has been really difficult, especially in the very beginning. When I was wearing the brace 24/7 and not taking it off and sleeping in it, I could hold on to the Velcro straps on there to like move my leg around. But when I am not wearing that, it gets pretty difficult to move my leg around. It's getting a lot easier now, but I was using a regular kitchen towel during my recovery a lot to assist with moving my leg. So I would just kind of like fold it up and like have my leg in there and be able to like move my leg around holding the towel. This was very helpful during the first couple weeks of my recovery. I would actually like hang it onto the crutches and just have it with me just in case I needed to move my leg around if I was somewhere not in bed, which was unusual. Which brings me to my next thing, which is a comfortable bed. So behind me is my new bed. I got this about a week before my surgery, and I actually ordered it off of Amazon, the bed and the bed frame. I don't know, I took a really big chance and it was such a great decision. The bed that I had before was a twin size bed and it was severely uncomfortable. I couldn't spend a lot of time in it without my back hurting, so I figured I couldn't get a bed worse than that one. When I bought this one off of Amazon, I actually got really lucky. I'll link it below. I'll link the bed and the bed frame. Can't really see the bed frame. It's super simple. This bed is awesome. I love it. It's so comfortable, and it's really made the recovery a lot better than it could have been if I didn't get it, because I've spent like 95% of the past 5.5 weeks in it. So it's made it a lot better. The next item is a little tray. It has legs that fold down. I think I'll just put a picture of it. This is also from Amazon. It's super nice quality, but it's really heavy. But it's a tray that you're supposed to be able to like sit across your lap while you're in bed and like use your computer. And that's what I thought that I was gonna be using it mostly for. I don't think I've really ever put my computer on it. I had to eat like all of my meals in bed for like the first 4 weeks of recovery because I couldn't sit at a table comfortably, so that was actually really nice for eating meals in bed. Also, since moving around was such a struggle, taking a shower was a lot more difficult than I had expected it to be. So the first week I didn't even attempt to get into the shower. I was like washing my hair in the sink in the bathroom, but eventually once I did get into the shower, we have like a shower bathtub combination thing, so you have to step over the bathtub to get in there, which is very difficult in this situation. So we got a stool for the shower, and then I was also using like a step stool. I think the stool was from Bed Bath & Beyond, and the step stool we just already had, and I'm still using them at this point because I just feel a lot safer in the shower. We also got one of those mats to put on the floor of the shower that has like suction cups in it, and that just makes it a little bit safer so I'm not like slipping in there, but I'm still not really standing in the shower just because it's very dangerous. After the first week of my recovery, I was allowed to start getting my incision wet. It was covered in strips of like medical tape, and over time as it got wet, it would start to come up. It would start start to like peel up on the sides. So I was instructed to like cut those pieces that had lifted up off with scissors. So I've just been using these little scissors. These are actually like crafting scissors, but you could use like cosmetic scissors. I wouldn't use like a gigantic pair of scissors because you're like cutting right next to your leg, but that was essential, having a pair of scissors to cut that tape off. And I just kept these on my nightstand, so as it would happen, I would just cut it off because I didn't want that tape that had like pulled up to get stuck on anything, like on a pant leg, and then rip off, because then like the scab would come off too soon. So these scissors were very helpful. And kind of to go along with those scissors, I was using lotion a lot around my leg. As that tape was coming up, the skin on my leg under that tape was super irritated. It was all dry and scaly and gross, so I was putting a lot of lotion on it. I was using the Jergens Hydrating Coconut Moisturizer. It's just a plain lotion that I know already doesn't cause me any irritation. Still use it all the time because the skin is like in super weird condition. We've talked about these before on this channel, but my swell bottle has been really nice to have during my recovery because it's super huge. This is the 25-ounce swell bottle. It keeps your water cold for 24 hours. It was just nice to have this because after someone would fill it up, it would be cold forever and it would last a while because it was really big. I have hardly left my house since I've had my surgery, but when I do leave, I gotta wear shoes. So I recommend a pair of slip-on sneakers. It's easy to just like stick my foot in this and then my shoe is on. I definitely wouldn't have been able to bend down and tie a sneaker for the first couple weeks, so the slip-on sneakers have been great. And one super surprising thing that I've been using a lot of during my recovery is cereal. Part of my tibia was like broken off and then moved and screwed into place. So during my recovery, I'm also healing a broken bone. So to me, that means that I should be drinking milk, you know, because that's like good for your bones, but I do not ever want to just drink a glass of milk. So I've been eating a lot of cereal, and once I was able to move around a little bit more, it was like the only thing that I could like prepare for myself. If you're gonna have surgery, your doctor is gonna tell you what kind of painkillers to use. I was told to take aspirin once a day for 6 weeks to prevent blood clots, and then using extra strength Tylenol after I stopped taking the narcotics. So those were essential for me, but your doctor would tell you what to take if you were going to be having surgery. So the last two and most important things that I've needed during my recovery is a really good physical therapist, some place that you feel comfortable going to, maybe a place that's not super far from your house. I really, really like the place that I'm going to for physical therapy. And going to physical therapy is a huge part of recovery. And two is a team of really great people to help you. So my parents, Chris, my grandma, they've all been really helpful. It's hard for me to not be independent and to not be able to do things on my own, but having a surgery like this that kind of puts you in bed for weeks is very difficult, and you have to have help. There's no way that you could do this without people to help you. So I'm very thankful that I had a lot of awesome people to help me during my recovery. And I mean, they're still helping me. I can't drive, I can't do a lot of stuff on my own, but there's no way that I would be able to have a surgery like this without having my family to be able to help me through it. So thank you for watching. Let me know in the comments what your surgery recovery essentials are, because I could use some pointers because I'm gonna have to have another one and I would like to know. Also, make sure to like and subscribe and follow us on Twitter and Instagram. I'll put those links down below.